is your process around failure? How do you look at that, and how do you kind of really springboard and grow from that?
Yeah, I've failed a lot. To me, setbacks were, you just got to keep going. If you believe in what you believe in, you learn from each one and you get better at what you do. If you keep doing the same thing again, that's madness. That never gets you anywhere. But if you keep growing and learning and reflecting and ducking and weaving and all the metaphors of sport and things like that, I mean, you find a way.
Approaching that dark period in the eye and moving forward and convincing your people to continue to move forward, because I believe nothing great in life comes easily.
You know, if you're going to be mountaineering, you have to make peace with the fact that you're going to fail a lot. And I'm really good at failing, you know, and I got spectacularly good at failing, you know, because more often than not, you're going to invest all this time, energy, purpose, resource into achieving something that you're not going to be successful achieving.
How do you deal with failure? I mean, because in the corporate world, there's constant failure, but being able to own that and be authentic, to sort of stick up your hand, seems to be quite a hurdle for a lot of people in the commercial world. But as an athlete, it seems to be one of the stepping stones to actually getting better and getting success.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, I always maintain we only learned anything from poor performances. When you're doing well, you just keep doing what you're doing. You don't challenge yourself. Status quo is good. Winning, boats flying, corporately, you know, we've been earning. It's only when you have a really, really poor performance that you go, holy crap, we've got to look at this.
We're much better now. There's so much more, a lot more research now on, building resilience, identifying what you need to get better at, feedback channels, you know, sometimes when someone tells you that you're not right for this role, doesn't mean you're actually a bad person, it just means you're not right for this role. So you might be right for another 10 great roles, it's just finding the role that you're best suited to. So I probably went through a few ebbs and flows with that, and definitely early in my career I felt like I was bottomed out a little bit, and then it wasn't until I was able to change that self-talk that I was able to build my confidence back in.
The first step to success is failure. I've always regarded failure as a detour and not a defeat. One of the abilities of strength is to look yourself in the mirror and say, look, I haven't succeeded in this, but what have I learned from it? That is a powerful individual force that hopefully you'll bear in mind when you tackle your next issue or next project.